backyard, pull up in your fast car, whistling my name. Open up a beer and you say get over here and play.
Hello, so welcome back to my channel. Basically, this is just like a paint with me video, but I didn't really film much of the process of me actually painting. So I woke up at like 3 a.m. in the morning and like I couldn't fall back asleep, so I decided to paint Hedy Lamarr. I think that's how you pronounce her name. And I tried to film the process, but it didn't go to plan as much as what I'd hoped it would go to plan. I just feel like there's a certain pressure with the whole camera being right next to you, and I feel like someone's watching me, even though there's no one watching me. So I kind of put the camera away and turned it off after a while, but I just wanted to speak about the process of doing this. So at first, this was an old canvas, and I used acrylic white gesso over the top of it and let it dry. It's been sitting in my room for months now. But the first thing I did was, well, obviously the sketch, and I finally found out what those little wooden things that, like, those wedges that are attached to the canvas are for, and it's for strengthening the canvas, and I had no idea, to stop it from sagging over time, which was a bit of a surprise. Anyway, I then used, I think it was raw umber oil colour, Winsor Newton, and raw umber, and I basically outlined the whole of the painting, of the sketch, I mean, and I panicked for a minute because I went over it as well. I went over the whole canvas in like a wash of burnt umber, but I noticed it was almost as if it was kind of like there was a lot of dust on the surface, and it was kind of chalky and crystal-like, as if, I don't know how to describe it, but it was just very, there was just a lot of, it felt like sandpaper a bit. So yeah, and I wasn't sure when to use the linseed oil, because I know I've learned so many methods of how to do oil painting, it's confusing on which one to stick to and which one not to stick to. So yeah, I think I like the method of doing an underpainting, because I've seen some people don't do an underpainting. I've seen some people do like a imprimatur, like a grey or dead colour kind of layer, grisaille layer, to get the values correct. And yeah, there's so many methods and it's so overwhelming, and I think I'll just stick to one method at a time, and the method I like the most is the underpainting and making a value based off of that underpainting. That's my favorite method. So here I'm just outlining the eyes and outlining all the details of the face, and yeah, a little bit of information about Hedy Lamarr, actually. So I'm just reading this off the Wikipedia page, but at the beginning of World War II, she and avant-garde composer George Antelli developed a radio guidance system for Allied torpedoes that used spread spectrum and frequency hopping technology to defeat the threat of jamming by the Axis powers. And I remember seeing a TikTok about her, and it was like, oh, I created Facebook. Oh, I created Instagram. And then it goes to her, I created Wi-Fi. And it's like this kind of idea that she kind of created the base foundation for all these things to function on. And although she isn't credited for it, she did come up with the idea of Wi-Fi, if I stand correct. And it's just something that's been washed away in history, really. And nobody really talks about it, but I just think it's very important that women in STEM are recognized for what they do. And she was a smart girl, and I just felt so moved by what she did, and I just wanted to paint her as well because she's beautiful. Now, I feel so embarrassed for wearing my bonnet while I'm, like, painting, but, like, it was, like, 7 a.m. and, like, I was still tired, and I literally was like, look, I can edit it out, right? Well, I was wrong. I can't edit it out, and next time I'll keep that in mind to make myself look a bit more presentable for, like, you guys. And yeah, I'm sorry for wearing my bonnet while I'm painting. Also, I noticed while I was painting, basically, it was like, I could see the hairs of the brush coming off and sticking onto my painting. And it was really annoying because I didn't know how to deal with it or how to get it off, so I just left it. Also, if you look very closely, you can actually see on her neck, there's like faint lines of sketch there, like some lips and a nose. This was actually originally going to be of my grandmother, but I didn't really, the scale put me off a bit. Like, I didn't really know how to do such a big scaled piece at that time, so I put it off. So, I really need to learn tips on how to kind of have the camera at one side and be kind of filming, because I'm so bad at it, it's terrible. I just need to just let go of that perfectionism of people are going to see my face in the shot, people are going to see my head in the shot, so I should just film what I can. And, you know, I'm very self-conscious about people seeing me in the shot, so that's why I kind of put the camera away and was like, look, I feel like it's an added pressure and I just want a clear mind and not having to worry about, is the camera in the right place, is the camera focusing, am I blocking the shot, am I too close to the canvas, kind of thing. Was 12 or something, I ordered 2 more wines, cause tonight I wanna. A little context if you care to listen. I find myself in a position. The man that I love sat me down last night and he told me that it's over, done decision. And I don't wanna feel how my heart is ripping. In fact, I don't wanna feel, so I stick to sipping. And I'm out on the town with a simple mission. In my little black dress and it's sitting. Just a heartbroken high heel, 6 inch in the back of the nightclub, sipping champagne. Trust any of these I'm with in the back of the taxi, sniffing calls, drunk texts, drunk tears, drunk sex. I was looking for a man who was on the same page. Back to the intro, back to the bar, to the Bentley, to the hotel, to my own way. Cause I don't wanna feel how I did last night. I don't wanna feel how I did last night. Doctor, doctor, anything please. Doctor, doctor, have mercy on me. Take
take this pain away.
You're asking me my symptoms, doctor. I don't wanna feel.
Talk this, how I'm blowing this thing. Back to my ways like 2019. No, 24 hours since my ex did that.
I got a new man on me, it's about to get sweaty.
Last night really was the cherry on the cake. Been some dark days lately and I'm finding it crippling. Excuse my state, I'm as high as your hopes that you'll make it to my bed, get me hot and sizzling. If I take a step back to see the glass half full, at least it's the Prada two-piece that I'm tripping in. And I'm already acting like a know me, so you might as well stick it. Just a heart broke, high heel 6 inch in the back of the nightclub sipping champagne. I don't trust any of these I'm with in the back of the taxi sniffing. Drunk text, drunk tears, drunk sex. I was looking for a man who was on the same page. Flash back to the intro, back to the bar, to the Bentley, to the hotel, to my old way.
Cause I don't wanna feel how I did last night. I don't wanna feel how I did last night. Anything please, have mercy on me and take this pain away.
You're asking me my symptoms, doctor. I don't wanna feel.
I don't wanna feel like I felt last night. I don't wanna feel like I felt last night.
Yeah, peace with the things you can't change. I'll be naked when I leave and I was naked when I came.
How to reach, how to test, too numb, I don't feel no way. So stuck, so what? Street smart, but it goes both ways. So, you're one bitch, you never escape. Sunset in the
rain. Give me my symptoms, doctor.
And this is the final piece. I think it still needs a bit more work to it and still needs a bit more, you know, toning out. I didn't do the background because I'm taking it to school somehow, some way. If I do manage to find a way to get it to school, wet. But yeah, thank you for watching and see you soon. Bye!